Okay, this is my first video for the holidays and to do some Pilates to get going. So we're going to start in our rest relaxation position. With our neck long and lengthened and focus on our breath. So taking a few breaths, three breaths in and out. And allowing our ribs to expand as we breathe in and close down as we breathe out. And taking the hands to the pelvis, engaging the lower core muscles and tilting and rolling in pelvic tilts. And then just slide the hands under the back of the hip bones, ready for knee openings. So engaging the lower core, the lower tummy muscles, opening the right knee and in. Just tuning into the body. So you want to keep the hip bones facing upright to the ceiling. And keeping the pressure even on the back of the hands. Breathing out. In. And out. And in. Then you can take the fingers into the small of the back. And engaging up and in through the pelvic floor. Feeling increased connection with the fingers under the mat. And bring the knee into knee fold. And alternating knee fold. So you want to watch for the difference. There should be no shift from right to left as you bring the knee into knee fold. And no shift in the spine from front to back. And then we can increase it to double knee fold. Again, no shift from right to left. And changing sides. Great. And bring the arms by the side for rib cage closure. Bring the arms up. Reaching towards the wall behind you and back, keeping the ribs down and back. And break. And bring the feet in a little bit for spine curls. From the pelvis, tilt and roll, wheel the spine out one bone at a time. And breathing out, rolling the spine down, one vertebra at a time. Initiate from the pelvis and the pubic bone. Exhale, breathing out. And let's add the arm raise. Arm over and roll the spine down. If you can't get your spine down evenly, then don't take the arms quite as far back. And last one. Rolling up. Over. And exhale down. And bring the arms down and out to the side. Palms up. Knees and feet together for hip rolls. Rotate. And to center. So you initiate from here, push from the center and pull back from the waist, keeping the shoulders down, pull back the waist, hips, pelvis, come back to center and back. Back to center, lovely. And bring the feet out to the side. Hands behind the head, nodding the chin, scooping the head, neck and shoulders up, keeping the hands where they are, or reaching forward. And curl up, snug the chin, scoop and down. If you prefer to keep the hands by the head, keep that neck supported. Then knee fold and down. Knee fold and down. Knee fold, leg long, bring it in and down. So, we can combine the movements. Scoop into curl up, knee fold, leg long, reach in and change. And long, bring it in and down and release. Press down, knee fold. Keeping the pelvis level and keeping the connection with the mat. All hands behind the head. In and lower, and again, nod, scoop, keep the head heavy in the hands, closing with the ribs, and pressing down, bring the hands behind the head for a few obliques, bring the right knee up, left elbow towards right knee, and lower, and repeat, and lower. Try to go up and towards that knee and keep it going. And three, two, one, and change. And two, three. Oh, it feels a bit weak on the side. Four, five, and six. Good. Into our dead bugs. Bring the arms up, bringing the knee up. Opposite arm and in. Or both arms and in. And in. Both arms. And let's change legs. And opposite arm and in. And both arms and in. And in. Keep the connection with the mat. Change it to double knee fold if you want to. Opposite arm and back to the start. Lengthen and back to the start. And back to the start. Into a modified double leg stretch and together. Reach and together. Reach if you want. You can do this in a curl up. Pressing down, hands to the outside of the knees, back and circle around, back and circle around. Keep the arms not going past your cheek. Ooh, I can feel that now. And back, and reach, and back, and back, and back. Hug the knees in and lower the head down, the knees in. Take a little rock side to side, hand on the right knee, hand on the left knee, draw in, open, oh, in, open and round. I've been riding again. Open, round and reverse. Great, a little few on our side, rolling onto the side. Either support the head with a neck cushion, down or rolled up tail, into a clown position. Knees bent, feet in line with the spine, shoulders over shoulders, hips stacked over hips, and watch the spine as long and lengthened. Starting with some basic clowns, we're going to lift the feet up, squeezing the heels, open and close. If you prefer the head down, just make sure it's slightly supported. Open and close. And then on the next one, we're going to stay up there and do some mini outer range. And two, and three, four, five, six, and rest down. And lengthen those legs, rolling onto your tummy. Pressing the head down for some diamond press. Elbows out to the side, legs relaxed. Head and chest peeling up. Long and lengthened spine. Exhale down. Lifting the head, chest forwards and up. And then peeling down. Keeping the back of the neck long. Watch we don't accidentally overdo the neck. So keeping the back of the neck long and coming down. Press and down. Press and down. Let's take it into a little bit of dart. Legs together, arms long and lengthened by your side. Hovering the arms up. Palms in, squeezing the bottom muscles, lifting the head and the chest, opening the shoulders up and in, up and down, in, up and down. And we can add a little bit of arm pumping for the back of the arms. And coming down. Great, on to the other side for clowns. Spine lengthened, feet together, head supported. Drawing in the tummy, raise the feet, coming long and lengthened in the spine. Open and close. Squeeze the heels. Close. Same speed up, same speed down. Open the knee and little pulses. One and two. Seven and eight and rest down. Great. Coming up onto your side and round into four point kneeling. If I'm still in the video. And into four-point kneeling, hands either side. Lengthen the spine from the pubic bone, tucking the tail underneath and around in your spine. Inhale, exhale, tailbone up, and head and chest lift. Inhale, around. And exhale. Inhale, around. And exhale, long and lengthen spine. Find a balance. You can drop down onto your forearms if you want to avoid the wrist, but make sure you push through your shoulders. So hands either side, strong through the shoulders, sliding the right leg out and lift and lower, keeping a still and stable spine. We can add the opposite arm and lower. Long, think length, stretch the arm and leg away as far as you can, trying to keep that jug balanced on your back. Swap sides. Slide and lengthen. Push the mat away from you. Lift and lower. Lift and lower. Focus on the tummy. And lift. And lower. And last one. And bring it back in. A nice rounded stretch. Dropping back onto your heels, stretch the arms forwards. If you can't bend the knees, have the bottom up and let the upper back stretch through between the shoulders. And round. Coming round into sitting, either sitting comfortably on the mat with legs long or bringing that below.